What's up, what's up, guys? What's up? How are you doing? I am back. It's Trish Divine. I am back again, guys, with another inspiration. I am back with motivation. And of course, I am back with education. Thank you for being here again, guys. I am back. I am back. I am back. Great to be back, guys. Okay, so I'm going to tell you a story. And the story for today, I don't have a moral for it, but listen to the story. This one is pretty much a joke. But okay, there was once this farmer. He had three daughters. His wife unfortunately passed away, so he had three daughters. Now he had to raise these three daughters on his own. He made sure that he looked out for them no matter what, and he always protected them because they were all he had left. Now, the daughters got to an age where they started dating. So they would go out on dates every now and again, and the farmer would make sure that everything was going okay. So there was one particular evening when these daughters decided to go out. All three of them decided to go on a date the same day at once. Anyway, the farmer, as usual, would meet the guys or greet the guys at the door with his shotgun. Of course, with his shotgun in his hand. Anyways, guys, the farmer stood at the door. The doorbell rang, so he went with his shotgun, you know, inspecting the young gentleman to see what's going on. The first gentleman came by and the farmer inspected him. He said, "Hi, my name is Joe. I am here for Flo. We're going to the show. Is she ready to go?" The farmer looked at him. "Okay, Flo, calm down." Said, "Okay, fine." Second guy came, rang the doorbell. The farmer looked at him also. He greeted the farmer, "Hi, my name is Eddie. I am here for Betty. We're gonna get some spaghetti. Is she ready?" Of course, the farmer looked him up and down with his shotgun in his hand. Betty was ready, so they went away. The third guy walked up. You know, the farmer inspecting him the same way with the gun in his hand, and the third guy walked up. He was like, "Hi, my name is Chuck." Guys, the farmer shot him. Yes, the farmer shot him. So, like I said, "Hi, my name is Chuck." The farmer shot him. You know why the farmer shot him. I need not say anything more, right? Yeah. Okay, guys, so into my inspiration of the day. Listen to this poem that I wrote for you guys. You may have lost a friend, still believe. Your health you can't seem to regain, but still believe. Troubles may seem as if they will never end, still believe. When life comes with lots of pain, just still believe. Never quit or on your dreams complacently sit. Still believe. You hear me, guys? Again, you may have lost a friend. Still believe. Your health you can't seem to regain, but still believe. Troubles may seem as if they will never end. Just still believe, guys. When life comes with lots of pain, still believe. Never quit. You hear me? Never quit or on your dreams complacently sit. Still believe. Still believe. What is the inspiration? What is the moral for this one? It's never too late in life for you to find success. It can never be too late, guys. And there is power. Trish Divine tell you, there is power in perseverance. You hear me? A lot of power can be found in perseverance. Be confident in yourself and never quit. You hear me? It's never too late for a shower rain. Be confident in yourself and never quit. And I'm going to leave you again with this word. There is power in perseverance. Push through hardship. Push through your struggle because there is power in perseverance. I've lived it. I've believed it. I've seen it. Been there and done that. There is so much power in perseverance. That's all you need to exercise. Perseverance. Just believe. Still believe, and you will always achieve. Trish Divine telling you that again, guys. One more time, thank you for stopping by, and you will definitely see me for another session, another day. Walk good, guys. Stay safe and abundantly love you. Always, Trish Divine. I will always love you, guys. Take it easy, and we'll talk another time. Take care.